Adil, Abdul, Rasheed, a leader in action, sought as the captain of Straightpath International School. He was born in Pakada Praya to Mr. Abdul Rasheed and Ms. Atika. Adil's academic and non-academic performance chart for the past 2.5 years reminds us of a phoenix bird.
As the head boy of Straightpath International School, I can proudly say that it's true in its motto, learning for both worlds. It's pure in nature and clear in practicing.
By the grace of God, he is blessed with an attractive character. He has volunteered to help the people in many circumstances like flood. May his helping hands and smiling face be lasted forever. Let's invite Adil Abdul Rasheed to the stage with a big round of applause.
Can I get an extract from the secret land of paradise? The mother asked Luqman al-Hakim. Seeing and experiencing a lovely mother, this little son needed no time to collect the soil of paradise. He came up with a portion of soil from the real heaven beneath the feet of his mother. Most beloved mothers and fathers, respected teachers, and all my dear friends. It's a matter of great pleasure and privilege to stand on this floor to talk about the sweet topic, mother. This becomes more exciting, particularly as I discuss this topic in the presence of my beloved mother. Isn't it a universal fact that mothers are valued in all traditions, cultures, scriptures, and religion? Yes, mothers are considered to be sacred in all religion, in true letter and spirit. The word mother itself is so sweet that tastes like honey and sounds like beautiful music. Dear friends, so what makes a mother so special? Is it the purity of her heart? Or is it the kindness and compassion she possesses? Or is it the love and care she exhibits? Or is it the boldness she demonstrates? It's hard to find out an answer for this question. First and foremost, a mother is special because she is a mother. A mother is special because of her nobility, character, commitment, unconditional love, care, so on and so on. Dear brothers and sisters, despite of all these facts, it's heartbreaking to note that the number of kids who leave their beloved mothers are increasing on a daily basis. You could see weeping mothers on the streets, sometimes on your doorsteps, with a torn baggage in hand, asking for your help. You could see such mothers in the confinement of old age home or care centers. They are everywhere, shedding tears of sorrows and loneliness. I remember one of my encounters with such a mother in a junction. It was dark and cold night. Everyone trying to get their home. Even the birds were flying fast to their nest. There I saw a mother with no more hopes, no foods to have, no water to drink, no blankets to wear, and no shelter to rest, except a plastic cover. These mothers also had a good past. They had carried their children on their laps. They had got extremely happy seeing their kids smiling and playing. They had filled their minds with the energy that they got from their kids. But now, when the kids are grown big, they have absolutely no issue in abandoning their dear mothers. Not even the slightest feeling of pain. Dears, can we forget the sleepless nights of our dear mothers? The time when we were in a womb, not knowing the worries and agonies that she suffered for us, taking care of us by her inner eye. The moment of confinement, suffering multiple times of pain, finding it hard to sit, stand, and walk, even to sleep. Is it easy to forget the hours that she forgot to have food and water? No, never, dears. We cannot forget that if our heart is still working. We cannot forget that if our emotions are still alive. We cannot forget that if we remember that for everything that we have today, she has played an important role in it. Hours after hours, days after days, weeks after weeks, months after months, and years after years, she has been there just for us. To see us smile, to see us happy, and to see us growing. It's painfully stunning that many of them are sent into the darkness of isolation. What they need is very simple. They need their kids by their side to talk to them, to ensure that they had food, to protect them from the fears and sorrows. Do you think it's difficult? No. Considering the amounts of efforts that they have put for us, we are doing nothing back to them. Yes, I said nothing. Words for sure won't be sufficient to talk about mother. That's the beauty of mothers, my dears. Let's keep our mother's smile always. Otherwise, even God will not forgive us. Treat them well, because they are the reasons for our happiness and comforts. Thank you. Have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.